Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. This is the second video on web technologies. Now we are discussing one of the buzz keywords used in web technologies. So words to know, that is the title we are making it account. But what are the keywords used in web technologies will be discussed, and later we need to know some of the basic fundamentals related to those topics. So now the first one is World Wide Web. It is also called as www, and we need to know what is web browser and HTTP, HTTPS and FTP, hypertext transfer protocol, hypertext transfer protocol security, and file transfer protocol, URL, uniform resource locator, and domain and hosting process. So now we need to know about these four topics. Before entering into the HTML, we need to know these topics, these keywords to know. The first one is World Wide Web. The World Wide Web is a network of computers that using the internet are able to exchange text, graphics, and even multimedia content using standard protocols. A set of HTML pages accessible using the HTTP protocol. So, in 1990 and 1991, Tim Berners-Lee created the World Wide Web at the European Laboratory for Practical Physics. The original purpose of the World Wide Web was to provide easy access to cross-reference documents that existing on the CERN computer network. Hypertext linking allows you to quickly open other web pages. So hypertext browsing, non-linear structure, it has no structure. You read what you want next and click on hypertext links to navigate from one page to another page in www. The features are graphical, means user friendly, easy to use, we can operate, there is no difficulty in the process. Cross platform means from one browser to another browser the view is same, and distributed, the data is sharing from one system to another system very easily. Dynamic, in the previous video that web pages are of two types, static and dynamic. The content will be changed dynamically. Interactive, from forms. Form means login page is one of the form. Creating an account is one form. Checking the mails is one form. Like, it interacts from one form to another form using Java or .NET or PHP, MySQL, etc. any one of the programming languages. Next, the second keyword is web browser. It is an interpreter to run HTML, CSS, JavaScript, etc. This is the exact definition of the web browser. People think that it executes the HTML page, but it is an interpreter. If you know the word interpreter means executing it. The purpose of web browser is to read HTML documents and display them as web pages. List any web browsers. One is Google Chrome, one of the popular thing. Second one is Internet Explorer, Mozilla Firefox, Safari, UC browser, etc. The web browser does not display the HTML tags but uses the tags to determine how the content of the HTML page is to be presented or displayed to the user. Next, in common user interface elements, web browsers common user interface elements: address bar for typing the domain name, URL name, and back and forward button moving to the back and moving to the next page. Bookmarking option, it means that we need to store in a web browser a refresh and stop button for refreshing and stopping the loading of content documents. Home button that gets you to your home page. These are the basic things. In the modern browser, so many user interface things are added, but commonly from all the browsers, these user interfaces are available. Now this is a typical diagram showing that what are the components available in the web browser. So one is user interface, next browser engine, next rendering engine, Next, data persistence, networking, JavaScript interpreter, UI background. User interface consists of address bar, home button, back and forward button, refresh button, stop button. All are available in user interface. Next, the browser engine is responsible for displaying the HTML content. The browser engine is responsible for displaying the HTML content. The render engine responsible for communicating from browser engine to rendering engine to request the support of networking, JavaScript or UI background. So networking means it takes the request from HTTP and according to that it will be responded. JavaScript interpreter means running JavaScript code with the help of the JavaScript interpreter. UI background back end, it is user interface back end. Combo box, text box and other things are available and those are displayed in your user interface. Next one, data persistence. It is the temporary storage available in web browser. Means bookmark and history, those data is stored in data persistence. So now in the next slide, we are explaining each and every component of the web browser. Once already I explained in detail, just I am reading the what the matter they typed here, what the matter we presented here. The user interface, this includes the address bar, back by forward button, bookmarking menu, etc. Every part of the web browser display except the main window where you see the requested page. The browser engine, the interface for querying and manipulating the rendering engine. The rendering engine responsible for displaying the requested content. For example, if the requested content is HTML, it is responsible for parsing the HTML and CSS and displaying the parsed content on the screen. Networking, used for network calls like HTTP requests. It has platform independent interface and underneath implementations for each platform. UI backend, used for drawing basic widgets like combo boxes and windows. It exposes a generic interface that is not platform specific. JavaScript interpreter, used to parse and execute the JavaScript code. Data storage, also called as data persistence. This is the persistence layer. The browser needs to save all sorts of data on the hard disk. For example, cookies. The new HTML specification defines web database, which is the complete database in the web browser. So now the third keyword is HTTP, HTTPS and FTP. Already I specified that HTTP means Hypertext Transfer Protocol is an application layer protocol for transmitting hypermedia documents such as HTML. It was designed for communication between web browser and web servers, but it can also be used for other purposes. HTTP follows a classical client server model. Client server means client is requesting to the server and the server is responded according to the client request. That is called client server model. With a client opening a connection to make a request, then waiting until it receives a response. HTTP is a stateless protocol, meaning that the server does not keep any data between two requests. So HTTP request and response, communication between client and servers is done by request and responses. A client, a browser sends an HTTP request to a web and web server receives the request. The server runs an application to process the request. The server returns an HTTP response to the browser. The client, the browser receives the response. Now, the second keyword, HTTPS. HTTPS means Hypertext Transfer Protocol Security, is an internet communication protocol that protects the integrity and confidentiality of data between the user's computer and the site. Users expect a secure and private online experience when using a web. We encourage you to adopt HTTPS in order to protect your users' connections to your website. Regardless of the content of the site. So data sent using HTTPS is secured via Transport Layer Security Protocol TLS, which provides three key layers of protection. One is encryption, second one is data integrity, third one is authentication. Encryption: encrypting the exchange data to keep it secure from airdroppers. That means that while the user is browsing a website, nobody can listen to their conversations, track their activities across multiple pages, or steal their information. Data integrity: data cannot be modified or corrupted during transfer, internationally or otherwise, without being detected. Authentication proves that your users communicate with the intended website. It protects against man-in-the-middle-hole attacks and builds user trust, which translates into other business benefit. So here, not secure is indicated means this is not HTTPS, it is only HTTP. If it is secure, it indicates with a lock key, then it is HTTP. Yes. Now, last one, FTP. FTP is short for File Transfer Protocol. A protocol is a set of rules that networked computers use to talk to one another. And FTP is the language that computers on a TCP by IP network use to transfer files to and from each other. You have probably encountered FTP out there on the net already. Ever downloaded a fresh nightly built on Firefox, or grabbed MP3s from some kid's personal server? Okay. Web development, you need all this functionality. Now, URL. URL stands for Uniform Resource Locator. A URL is nothing more than the address of a given unique resource on the web. In theory, each valid URL points to a unique resource. Such resources can be an HTML page, a CSS document, an image, etc. In practice, there are some exceptions, the most common being a URL pointing to a resource that no longer exists or that has moved. As the resource represented by the URL and the URL itself are handled by the web server, it is up to the owner of the web server to carefully manage that resource and its associated URL. Let us assume the IP address is 127.123.142.116 is an IP address. We cannot remember this IP address for a long time. Instead of write, we are changing this IP address to some website names. This is an example, not exactly it works. Okay, so this name is understood by the user when compared to the IP address. So that this is called URL or domain name. After, we need to create a domain name, and we are buying a space on the web server, and we need to host it. Hosting is nothing but sharing the local system files into remote system files, and directly we need to type the web domain. Automatically the web pages will be displayed. So this is one of the rare picture available on the internet, that this is the first web browser Tim Berners-Lee introduced. Thank you.